I used to live in this little flat up at the top of a house, in a little room I had, and I had a piano by the bed. And I just woke up one morning with this tune in my head. I thought, I don't know this tune, or do I? It's like an old jazz tune or something, and I've, because my dad used to know a lot of old jazz stuff. Well, maybe I've just remembered it or somewhere. So I sort of went to the piano, found the chords to it. You know, it was like in G, F sharp minor, 7, sort of B and that. And kind of just remembered it, made sure I remembered it. And then I just hawked it round to all my friends and stuff and said, what's this? You know, it's got to be something. It's like a good little tune, you know, and I couldn't have written it because I just dreamed it, you know. You don't get that lucky.
And it wasn't until he got the lyric together that he decided to record it. And he said, how should we do it? I said, well, it's a lovely song, super song. I can't really see what Ringo can do on it. I can't really see what heavy electric guitars are going to do on it. Why don't you just go down there and sing it to me with a guitar and we'll decide what to do with it then?
And it was good, actually, because all the others, the guys, I looked at them like, oops. I mean, you know, solo record. And they said, yeah, you know, it doesn't matter. There's nothing we could add to it, so do it.
And so, for Paul McCartney of Liverpool, opportunity knocks. Yesterday. Thank you, Ringo. That was wonderful.
And I remember John listening to it. And there's a particular bit where the cello moves into a kind of bluesy note. And John thought that was terrific. So it was applauded. But it wasn't really a Beatle record. And I discussed this with Brian. I said, you know, this is Paul's song. Should we call it Paul McCartney? He said, no.
And I can't actually remember him making that suggestion, but I wouldn't have done that. You know, we never entertain those ideas. It was sometimes tempting, you know, people would flatter you and say, oh, you know, you should get out front on the band there, or you should put this solo record out. But we always said, nah. In fact, we didn't even ever put it out as a single in England, because we were kind of a little bit embarrassed about it. We were a rock and roll band, you know, we thought we were like a little R&B combo.